Hi, this is Amal Purwagar. In this session, we are going to discuss on introduction to smart material. This session will contain what is smart materials, features of it, examples of smart materials, cross coupling in material properties, classification of smart materials. At end of the session, we can elaborate one by one of piezoelectric materials, magnetostatic materials, shape memory alloys, electro or magnetorheological materials. Smartness can measure in intelligence scale. If you form a scale from stupid to wise, you can measure the smartness in between, from sensible, the highly sensible to core intelligence. So those, in case of materials, those materials are capable to sensible or poorly intelligent, then the material can classify it under the smart materials. By definition, smart materials are the materials which possess the ability to change their physical properties in a specific manner in response to specific stimulus input. Where the input could be pressure, temperature, electric and magnetic fields, chemicals, hydrostatic pressures or nucleus radiations. The output or physical properties may be shape of the material, stiffness of the material, viscosity or the damping capability. Smartness of the material may describes by some characteristics, for example, functional materials, self-adaptivity, cellular in function, self-sensing, memory of the material. Functional materials may explain by some examples. If you apply a force on a traditional material, there will be a deformation, mechanical deformation, means there will be a strain. In case of smart materials, it will not be only strain, there will be something more. There may be a some electricity. The mechanical deformation may generate some electricity. This electricity is known as a piezoelectricity. We will see in coming slides. So this behavior is known as a smartness. Here we are applying force, there will be a deformation. Along with there will be a generation in electricity. This is known as, this material is known as functional materials. Self-adaptivity. Some materials will change its behavior according to the environmental change. For example, if you change the temperature of that material, it will change its stiffness. This kind of materials are known as shape memory alloys. Next, cellular in function. The smart materials will have capable to survive even though if it is broken into the pieces. Let's take an example, practical example. If you separated a cell from human, if you provide an environment to that, it will survive. So like that, the smart materials always cellular in function, and it have capable to self-sensing. It's highly sensible in nature, and some of the materials will have capable to memorize its shape with respect to physical properties. With the above characteristics, the smart materials may provide numerous possible applications in various fields as sensors, actuators, and control mechanisms. This is material properties matrix. Here we can cross-couple and it will describe the smartness of the material. Let's take in this matrix, the rows are indicating inputs and the columns are indicating output. Let's take the stress row and the strain column. Here the intersection will provide elastic modulus, which describes the traditional design criteria. It's nothing but Hooke's law. Here the stress is directly proportional to strain, thus proportionality constant is a elastic modulus. Likewise, each intersection will describe some laws and the system will undergo according to that law. If you want your system to sense a stress in terms of electricity, then the intersection will provide direct piezoelectric effect. Here the system will going to act as a sensor of stress in terms of electricity. If you take this, the Villari effect, if you want to sense a stress in terms of magnetic field, then the system will have to act under the Villari effect. Like that, this row will give us as different sensors of stress. If you take this column, if you want to produce strain, if you want to generate strain, means mechanical deformation by means of electricity, then the system should work under the reverse piezoelectric effect. Here the material will going to act as an actuator. Like this, in this column will explaining the actuators. If the mechanical deformation produced due to magnetic field, the system will working under the Joule's effect or magnetostatic effect. Like that, it will be going on. With the example, we can get more clarity on behavior of the smart materials and its basic principles. If you apply stress on a material, it may produce electric charges, means electricity. Then the material is known as a piezoelectric material. Here the role of the material will be acting as a sensor, and basic principle of the behavior of the material is piezoelectric effect. If you apply electric field or electricity on a material, it may produce stress. Then the material is known as the same piezoelectric material, but the basic principle is a reverse piezoelectric effect. Here the role of the material is actuators. If you apply a heat on a material, It may change to its original memorized shape or its initial shape. Then the material is known as a shape memory alloys. Here the role of the material is actuators and the basic principle is phase changing. You may apply electric field on a material. It may produce change in viscosity. Or internal damping capacity may change according to the electricity. Then the material known as electrorheological fluid. Here the role of the material is vibration controller, control mechanism, and the basic principle is electrical rheology. You may apply a magnetic field, you may get mechanical deformation or strain. Then the material known as magnetostrictive materials. Here the role of the material is actuator, and basic principle is magnetostrictive effect or Joule's effect. It's also known as Joule's effect. The reverse or converse effect also possible, where the role of the material may sensor. Classifications of smart materials. Smart materials broadly classified into active smart materials and passive smart materials. Active smart materials are having capability to modify their geometry or mechanical property under the application of different physical properties, for example electrical property, thermal, magnetic field, etc. So ultimately it may have capable to act as an actuator. It may transduce energy. The best examples for active smart materials are piezoelectric materials, shape memory alloys, electrorheological fluids, and magnetostrictive materials, etc. Here, these materials are highly capable to force transducers and actuators. But in case of passive smart materials, it doesn't have capability to act as a transducer or actuators. The best example for passive smart materials is fiber optic materials. It's a highly sensible in nature, but it won't acting as an actuator. With this classification, we wind up this session. In next session, we will see the different smart materials, for example, piezoelectric materials, magnetostrictive materials, shape memory alloys, and electrorheological fluids. Thank you.